वेलकम बैक एवरीवन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 15, लाइट। यू माइट हैव सीन अ बीम ऑफ सनलाइट व्हेन इट एंटर्स अ रूम थ्रू अ नैरो ओपनिंग और अ होल। यू मे हैव ऑल्सो सीन बीम्स ऑफ लाइट फ्रॉम हेडलाइट्स ऑफ स्कूटर्स, कार्स एंड इंजन्स ऑफ ट्रेन्स। इन फिगर 15.1 शोज द इंजन्स ट्रेन हाईलाइट हेडलाइट। सिमिलरली अ बीम ऑफ लाइट कैन बी सीन फ्रॉम अ टॉर्च। Some of you may have seen a beam of search light from a lighthouse or from an airport tower. So you can see here it is a lighthouse and here is a beam of light. What do you experience? What do these experiences suggest? So we will see that. 15.1, lights travel along a straight line. So you can see here he is looking at a candle through a straight and a bent pipe. Light travels along a straight line. Bojo recalls an activity he performed in class 6. In that activity, he looked at a lighted candle first through a straight pipe and then through a bent pipe. So Bojo tried to look at the lighted candle through a straight pipe and a bent pipe. Why was Bojo not able to see the candle flame through a bent pipe? So he was not able to see the light through the bent pipe. This activity showed that light travel along straight line. So this shows that the light travel along a straight line. How can we change the path of light? Do you know what happens when a light falls on polished or a shiny surface? So it is called reflection. 15.2, reflection of light. One way to change the direction of light is to let it fall on a shiny surface. So when we let the light fall on a shiny surface, it changes its direction. For example, a shining stainless steel plate or a shining steel spoon can change the direction of light. The surface of water can also act like a mirror and change the path of light. Have you ever seen the reflection of tree or buildings in water? So you can see here the trees are visible on the water surface. It is acting like a mirror, reflection of objects in water. Any polished or a shiny surface can act as a mirror. What happens when light falls on a mirror? You have learnt in class 6 that a mirror changes the direction of light that falls on it. This change of direction by the mirror is called reflection of light. Can you recall the activity in which you got the light of a torch reflected from a mirror? Let us perform the similar activity. So Pahali remembers the story of the lion and the rabbit from the Panchatantra, in which the a rabbit fooled the lion by showing him his reflection in water. In figure 15.5, you can see the lion is seeing himself in water. Reflection of lion in the water. Activity 15.1, take a torch, cover its glass within with a chart paper which has three narrow slits as shown in figure 15.5. Spread a sheet of chart paper on a smooth wooden board. Fix a plane mirror strip vertically on the plane on the chart paper. You can see it in figure 15.6. Place the torch in a way that its light is seen along the chart paper on the board. Now adjust its position so that the light from the torch strikes the plane mirror at an angle. Does the mirror change the direction of light that falls on it? Now move the torch slightly to either side. Do you find any change in the direction of the reflected light? Pahali wants to know what makes things visible to us. Bojo thinks that objects are visible only when light reflected from them reaches to our eyes. Do you agree with them? Look into the mirror along the direction of the reflected light. Do you see the slits on the mirror? This is the image of the slits. This activity shows how light gets reflected from a mirror, plane mirror. Let us play around with the image formed on mirror and know a little more about them. So activity 15.2, there is a word of caution here. Handle the lighted candle with care. It is better if this activity is performed in presence of teacher or an elder person. Place the lighted candle in front of a plane mirror. Try to see the flame of the candle in the mirror. It appears as if a similar candle is placed behind the mirror. The candle which appears behind the mirror is the image of the candle formed by the mirror. The candle itself is the object. So you can see इट लुक्स लाइक एन अनदर सिमिलर कैंडल इज लाइटेड बिहाइंड द मिरर. नाउ मूव द कैंडल टू डिफरेंट पोजिशंस इन फ्रंट ऑफ द मिरर. ऑब्जर्व द इमेज इन ईच केस. इमेज ऑफ कैंडल इन अ प्लेन मिरर. सो बोजो नोटेड इन हिज नोटबुक, इज इट नॉट सरप्राइजिंग दैट माई इमेज इज ऑफ द सेम साइज ऑफ मी वेदर द मिरर इज स्मॉल और लार्ज. वॉज द इमेज अपराइट इन ईच केस. डिड द फ्लेम अपियर ऑन टॉप ऑफ द कैंडल एज इन द ऑब्जेक्ट. सच एन इमेज इज कॉल्ड इरेक्ट. सो इट इज कॉल्ड इरेक्ट इमेज. एन इमेज फॉर्म बाय प्लेन मिरर इज इरेक्ट एंड ऑफ द सेम साइज ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट. सो दिस इज द इमेज विच इज फॉर्म्ड एज इरेक्ट एंड हैज द सेम साइज. नाउ प्लेस अ वर्टिकल स्क्रीन बिहाइंड द मिरर. सो बिहाइंड द मिरर यू शुड प्लेस अ वर्टिकल स्क्रीन. Try to obtain the image of the candle on this screen. Can you get the image on the screen? Now place the screen in front of the mirror. Can you get the image on the screen now? You will find that the image of the candle cannot be obtained on the screen on the either case. What about the distance of the image from mirror? Let us perform another activity. So activity 15.3. Take a chessboard. If a chessboard is not available, draw a chart paper 64 8 into 8 square of equal size. So make 64 square of equal size. Draw a thick line in the middle of the paper. Fix a plane mirror vertically on this line. Place any small object such as a pencil sharpener at the boundary of the third square counting from the mirror. So you can put the sharpener from the third square from the mirror. Place any small object such as a pencil sharpener at the boundary of the third square counting from the mirror as in figure 15.7. Note the position of the image. Now shift the object to the boundary of the fourth square. Again note the position of the image. Do you find any relation between the distance of the object from the mirror and that of the object in front of it? So Pahali made a note in her notebook. In a plane mirror, the image is formed behind the mirror. It is erect and of the same size and is at the same distance from the mirror as the object is in the front of it. You will find that the image is at the same distance behind the mirror as the object is in the front of it. Now verify this by placing the object anywhere on the chart paper. So you will see that the image is formed at the same distance and when it is in the behind the mirror when the object is in front of it. 15.3 right or left. When you see your image in a plane mirror, it is exactly like you. Have you ever noticed that there is one interesting difference between you and your image in the mirror? Let us find out. Activity 15.4. Stand in front of a plane mirror and look at your image. Raise your left hand. Which hand does your image raise? Now touch your right ear. Which ear does your hand touch in your image? Observe carefully. You will find that in the mirror the right appears left and the left appears right. Note that the only sides are interchanged. The image does not appear upside down. So only the sides appear interchanged, but the image does not appear upside down. Now write down your name on a piece of paper and hold it in front of the plane. So the student is raising his left hand and in the mirror his right hand is raised. Mirror, how does it appear in the mirror? So you can see an ambulance. So it is written like this so that the mirror can see it in the right form. Bojo saw an ambulance on the road. He was surprised to see that the word ambulance in front was written in a strange manner. Can you now understand why the word ambulance is written in the figure 15.9? When the driver of the vehicle ahead of the ambulance look in his or her rear view mirror, she or he can read ambulance written on it and give way to it. It is the duty of every one of us to allow an ambulance to pass without blocking its way. You might have observed that in the side mirror of the scooter or a car, the image of all objects appears smaller than the object themselves. Have you ever wondered why it is so? So in 15.4, playing with spherical mirrors. Pahali and Bojo were waiting for their dinner. Bojo lifted a stainless steel plate and saw his image on it. Oh, this plate acts as a plane mirror. My image is erect and is of the same size. Pahali saw her image using द बैक ऑफ द स्टील स्पून, बोजो लुक हियर, आई कैन ऑल्सो सी माई इरेक्ट इमेज थ्रू इट, इट इज स्मॉलर दो इट इज स्मॉलर इन साइज, दिस स्पून ऑल्सो एक्ट एज अ मिरर ऑफ सम काइंड, सेड पहेली, कैन यू यू कैन ऑल्सो यूज अ स्पून और एनी कर्व्ड शाइनिंग सरफेस टू सी योर इमेज. एक्टिविटी 15.5, टेक अ स्टेनलेस स्टील स्पून, ब्रिंग द आउटर साइड ऑफ द स्पून नियर योर फेस, लुक इन टू इट. Do you see your image in it? As in figure 15.10, you can see here. In this image, different from what you see in the plane mirror. Is the image erect? Is the size of the image the same, smaller or larger? So image of the outer side of the spoon. Now look at your image using the inner side of the spoon. This time, you may have find that your image is erect and larger in size. If you increase the distance of the spoon from your face, you may see the image inverted. So you can see the image is inverted upside down in figure 15.11. You can also compare the image of your pen or pencil instead of your face. Image from the inner side of the spoon. The curved shining surface of a spoon acts as a mirror. The most common example of curved mirror is spherical mirror. It is reflecting surface. If the reflecting surface of the spherical mirror is concave, it is called a concave mirror. If the reflecting surface of is convex, then it is called a convex mirror. So you can see it is a con in A it is a concave and in B it is a convex mirror. Why a concave and convex mirror are called spherical mirror? Take a rubber ball and cut a portion of it with a knife or a hacksaw blade, as in figure 15.13a. Be careful, ask an elderly person to help you in cutting the ball. The inner surface of the cut ball is called the concave, and the outer surface of the surface is called a convex, as you can see in figure B. A spherical mirror is a part of a sphere, so it is called a spherical mirror. The inner surface of a spoon acts like a concave mirror, while its outer surface acts like a convex mirror. We know that the image of an object from a plane mirror cannot be obtained on a screen. Let us investigate if it is also true for the image formed by the concave mirror. So activity 15.6, there is a word of caution. You will conduct activity 15.6 in sunlight. Be careful, never look directly towards the sun or its image, as it may damage your eyes. You may look at the image of the sun when it is thrown on a screen or a wall. So you can see it here. A concave mirror forms a real image of the sun. Take a concave mirror, hold it facing the sun. Try to get the light reflected by the mirror on a sheet of paper. Adjust the distance of the paper until you get a sharp bright spot on it. Hold, as in figure 15.14, hold the mirror and the sheet of paper steady for a few minutes. Does the paper start burning? This bright spot is in fact the image of the sun. Notice that the image is formed on the screen. An image formed on a screen is called a real image. So when the image is formed on a screen, it is called a real image. Recollect that in activity 15.2, the image formed by a plane mirror could not be obtained on a screen. Such an image is called a virtual image. Now let us try to obtain on the screen the image of a candle flame formed by a concave mirror. In 15.7 activity, fix a concave mirror on a stand. Any arrangement to keep the mirror steady would do. And place it on a table as in figure 15.15. Place a piece of white paper on a cardboard sheet, say about 15 centimeter into 10 centimeter. This will act as a screen. Keep a lighted candle on the table at a distance of about 15 centimeter from the mirror. So try to obtain the image of the flame on the screen. For this, move the screen till the sharp image of the flame is obtained. Make sure that the screen does not obstruct the light from the candle falling on the mirror. Is this image real or virtual? Is it on the same size as of the flame? Now move the candle towards the mirror and place it at a different distance from it. In each case, try to obtain the image on the screen. Record your observation in table 15.1. Is it possible to obtain the image on the screen when the candle is too close to the mirror, as in figure 15.16? You can see virtual image formed by a concave mirror. So you can see here, we can see that the image formed by a concave mirror can be smaller or larger in size than the object. The image may be also be real or virtual. Concave mirror are used for many purposes. You might have seen doctors using concave mirror for examining ears, eyes, nose and throat. Concave mirrors are also used by dentists to see an enlarged image of the teeth, as in figure 15.17. The reflectors of torches, headlights of cars and scooters are concave in shape. So you can see here the dentist is watching the teeth in a larger form in a concave mirror. So Bojo observed his image in the shiny surface of the bell on his new bicycle. He found that his image was erect and smaller in size. He wondered. So you can see here, it is in a torch also, the reflector is made of a concave surface. If the bell is also of a kind of spherical mirror, can you recognize the type of the mirror? Note that the reflecting surface of the bell is convex. So the reflective surface of the bell was convex. Activity 15.8. Repeat activity 15.7 now with a convex mirror. In place of a concave mirror, as in figure 15.9, record your observation in the table similar to table 15.1. Could you get a real image at any distance of the object from the convex mirror? So you can write your observation here. Distance of the object from the mirror. First is 50, 40, 30, 10, 20, 10 and very close 5 centimeter. Smaller or larger than the object. So you can write here. Inverted or erect image. It is a characteristic, and real or virtual image. This is also characteristic. So you can fill the table. So you can see here the rear mirror of a car or a bus. So do you get an image larger in size than the object? Can you now recognize the mirrors used on the side mirrors on automobiles? These are convex mirrors. Convex mirrors can form images of objects spread over a large area. So these help the driver to see the traffic behind them. So you can see here, he can see the full view of the traffic behind him because of the help of a convex mirror. 15.5, image formed by lenses. You might have seen a magnifying glass. It is used to read very small print. As in figure 15.21, you can see that. You might have also used it to observe the body part of a cockroach or an earthworm. The magnifying glass is actually a type of a lens. Lenses are widely used in spectacles, telescopes and microscopes. Try to add a few more uses of lenses to this list. Get some lenses, touch and feel them. Can you find some differences just by touching? Those lenses which feel thicker in the middle than on the edges are convex. So the lenses which are thicker in the middle than the edges is a convex mirror, as in figure 15.22. You can see a 15.22A is a convex lens. So because it is thicker in the middle, and this is a concave mirror, concave lens, because it is thinner in the middle and larger in the surface edges. So you can see the magnifying glass here. So you can zoom the text to read them by a magnifying glass, which feels thinner in the middle than and the at the edges are concave lenses. So you have seen that in the figure B. Notice that the lenses are transparent and light can pass through them. So through the lenses, the light can pass. Let us play with lenses. A word of caution is here. It is dangerous to look through a lens at the sun or a bright light. You should also be careful not to focus sunlight with a convex lens on any part of your body. So you should not focus the light sunlight of a with a convex lens on any part of your body. It may be dangerous. Activity 15.9. Take a convex lens or a magnifying glass. Put it in the path of a sun ray. Place a sheet of paper as shown in figure 15.23. Adjust the distance between the lens and the paper till you get a bright spot on the paper. So you can see here, you should adjust it and a bright spot will appear on the paper. Hold the lens and the paper in this position for a few minutes. Does the paper begin to burn? Now replace the convex lens with a concave lens. Do you see a bright spot on the paper this time? Two, why you are not getting a bright spot this time? We have seen in the case of mirrors that the different position of the objects of nature and sizes of the image changes. Is it true for lenses also? Let us find it out. Activity 15.10, take a convex lens and fix it on a stand as you did with the concave mirror. Place it on a table. Place a lighted candle at the distance of about 50 cm from the lens as in figure 15.25A. Try to obtain the image on the candle or of the candle on a paper. Place on the other side of the lens. You may have to move the screen towards or away from the lens to get a sharp image from the lens to get a sharp image of the flame. What kind of image do you get? Is it real or virtual? Now vary the distance of the candle from the lens as in figure 15.25B. Try to obtain the image of the candle flame every time on the paper screen by moving it. Record your observation as you did in activity 15.7 for the concave mirror. So you can see here, a convex lens converges, bend inwards, the light generally falling on it. So you can see the convex mirror lens will bend inwards towards the light towards the towards the screen, and therefore it is called a converging lens. On the other hand, a concave lens will diverge, bend outwards the light. So you can see it here in the B, the concave lens will bend the light outwards. So it is called a diverging lens. So it is clear now that the concave mirror is a diverging and convex mirror is a converging lens. The convex lens is converging lens and concave lens is diverging lens. It means that we can see image formed by lens from the side opposite to that of the object. So you can see it here. Screen the images in image by convex lens for the object placed at a different distance. So you can see through a convex lens the image placed at a different, so the virtual image is formed by a convex lens and image formed by you can see it here, the image formed by a concave mirror, concave lens. Do you get in any position of the object an image which was erect and magnified as in figure 15.26? So you can see here, could this image be obtained on a screen? Is the image real or virtual? This is how a convex lens is used as a magnifying glass. It is in a similar fashion, study the image formed by a concave lens. You will find that the image formed by a concave lens is always virtual, erect and smaller in size than the object. So you can see here in 27, the object is smaller and erect. In the above image you can see. Sunlight, white or colored. Have you ever seen a rainbow in the sky? You might have noticed that it appears usually after the rain when the sun is low in the sky. The rainbow is seen as a large arc in the sky with many colors as in figure 15.28. How many colors are present in a rainbow? When observed carefully, there are 7 colors in a rainbow. Though it may not be easy to distinguish all of them, these are red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo and violet. Does this mean that the white light consists of 7 colors? So you can see it when you pass a white light through a prism, you can see the 7 lights. A prism split a beam of sunlight into a 7 color. So you can see a CD placed in a sun. You might have seen that when a blow soap bubble, they appear colorful. Similarly, when the light reflected from the surface of a compact disc CD, you see many colors. Figure 15.29. On the basis of these experiences, could we say that the sunlight is a mixture of different colors? Let us investigate. In activity 15.11, take a glass prism. Allow a narrow beam of sunlight through a small hole in the window of a dark room to fall on one face of the prism. So, Pahali wants to tell you that you can see a rainbow only when योर बैक इज टुवर्ड्स द सन, सो इट इज क्लियर. लेट द लाइट कमिंग आउट ऑफ द अदर फेस ऑफ द प्रिज्म फॉल ऑन अ व्हाइट शीट ऑफ पेपर और अ व्हाइट वॉल. व्हाट डू यू ऑब्जर्व? डू यू सी कलर सिमिलर टू दोज इन द रेनबो एस इन फिगर 15.30? सो दिस शोज दैट द लाइट सनलाइट कंसिस्ट ऑफ सेवन कलर. द सनलाइट इज सेड टू बी व्हाइट कलर. दिस मीन्स दैट द व्हाइट लाइट कंसिस्ट ऑफ सेवन कलर्स. ट्राई टू आइडेंटिफाई दिस कलर्स एंड राइट देयर नेम्स इन योर नोटबुक. कैन बी मिक्स दिस कलर्स टू गेट व्हाइट कलर? लेट अस ट्राई आउट. एक्टिविटी 15.12. टेक अ सर्कुलर कार्डबोर्ड डिस्क इन अ ऑफ अबाउट 10 सेंटीमीटर डायमीटर. डिवाइड दिस डिस्क इंटू सेवन सेगमेंट. पेंट द सेवन रेनबो कलर्स ऑन दिस सेगमेंट्स एज शोन इन द फिगर 15.31. सो यू कैन पेंट सेवन कलर्स ये एज यू कैन सी हेयर इन द 15.31A. यू कैन ऑल्सो पेस्ट कलर्ड पेपर्स ऑन दिस सेगमेंट्स. मेक अ स्मॉल होल ऑन द सेंटर ऑफ द डिस्क. फिक्स द डिस्क लूजली ऑन द टिप ऑफ अ रिफिल ऑफ अ वॉल पेन. इंश्योर दैट द डिस्क रोटेट्स फ्रीली. फिगर 15.31A रोटेट द डिस्क इन अ डे लाइट. वेन दिस डिस्क इज रोटेटेड फास्ट द कलर गेट्स मिक्सड टू बी वाइटिश. फिगर 15.31B शोज दैट सच अ डिस्क इज पॉपुलरली नोन एज द न्यूटन्स डिस्क. सो हियर इज अ डिस्क विथ सेवन कलर एंड बी इट अपियर्स वाइटी ऑन रोटेटिंग. पहली हैज अ ब्रिलियंट आइडिया. शी हैज प्रिपेयर्ड अ स्मॉल टॉप विथ अ स्मॉल सर्कुलर डिस्क विथ सेवन रेनबो कलर्स पेंटेड ऑन इट एज इन फिगर 15.32. When the top rotates, it appears nearly white. So you can see it here. So Paheli had a brilliant idea of creating this top. So when we rotate this top, it will appear as if it is white. So here the chapter is finished, and now we will see in a nutshell what we have learned so far. Light travels along a straight line. Any polished or shining surface acts as a mirror. An image which can be obtained on a screen is called a real image. So when an image is obtained on a screen, it is called a real image. An image which cannot be obtained on a screen is called a virtual image. The image formed by a plane mirror is erect. It is virtual and is of the same size as the object. The image is at the same distance behind the mirror as the object is in front of it. In an image formed by a mirror, the left side of the object is seen to be on the right side of the image, and right side of the image appears to be on the left side of the image, as you have seen in the figure of the boy lifting the hand. A concave mirror can form a real or inverted image. When the object is placed very close to the mirror, the image formed is virtual, erect, and magnified. Image formed by a convex mirror is erect, virtual, and smaller in size than the object. So image formed by a convex mirror is erect, virtual, and smaller in size than the object. A convex lens can also form real and inverted image. A convex lens also form real and inverted image. When the object is placed very close to the lens, the image formed is virtual, erect, and magnified. When used to see objects magnified, the convex lens is called a magnifying glass. A concave lens always forms erect, virtual, and smaller image than the object. So concave lens always forms erect, virtual, and smaller image than the object. White light is composed of seven color. So here our chapter 15 is finished, and we shall stop here, and we will start the next chapter in the next class. Thank you.